The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beat! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you've downloaded and installed it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
I miss the taste of the sweet life. I miss the conversation. I'm searching for a song tonight. I'm changing all of the stations.
I was there for you when your darkest night. But I wonder where we are when I was out, my worst night.
a lot of people throw a negative criticism the way of Maroon 5 for some of their newer stuff, including that one, Maps. A lot of people not really into it as they were their throwback songs, such as Misery and She Will We Love. Remember those? Really big fan of those when you talk about throwback singles. And however, since Payphone was dropped in 2012, voted the biggest breakup song of that year, actually, Maroon 5 have been told by their fans they're not really putting out in terms of number one hit singles on the Billboard chart anymore, including that one, Maps, Sugar, and Animals. Give me your opinion in conjunction with all the negative criticism thrown the way of Maroon 5 on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment. You can tweet it to me on Twitter at JonathanClark1. Let me know what's up. We are broadcasting over on our YouTube channel with 56,000 channel views, nearly 2,000 videos uploaded. A lot of subscribers on our YouTube channel getting in on the conversation. We invite you to subscribe. So go to YouTube.com/JonathanClark22. Hit subscribe at the top of our channel and get in on the conversation. Follow us on Twitter with over 40,000 tweets. In the way of exclusive news, photos, and videos at JonathanClark1. So much stuff being talked about over there. Really excited about some of the worldwide premieres coming up theatrically this weekend. Jurassic World. Expecting that one to dominate and take over in the box office. I am with every Jurassic Park fan of the 90s and early 2000s today. I am with you wherever you're listening this podcast, whether it be on a wireless device, whether it be from a laptop or a computer. If you're going up to see Jurassic World tonight, I am with you. Really big fan of the original Jurassic Park movies, and the revamping of this one expected to be just as big. Give me your opinion on that on our Facebook page at ETW Entertainment, on Twitter at JonathanClark1. The Twitter feud between Taylor Swift and Katy Perry not going anywhere. Ever since the release of Taylor Swift's highly anticipated single, her third number one off her album 1989 Bad Blood, the title track called Bad Blood, of course, with some rapping from Taylor Swift incorporated into this new single. Some newer stuff from Taylor Swift, referring to Ghost as one of Katy Perry's singles from her 2013 album Prism. Draw your own conclusions when it comes to that. Give me your opinion on Facebook and Twitter of this Twitter feud, which doesn't seem to be going anywhere or dying down between Taylor Swift and Katy Perry, especially with this premiere of this new single from Taylor Swift, of course, called Bad Blood. You can download it now on iTunes. A lot of stuff being talked about, but it seems the authority in WWE have been getting on my nerves so much, in fact, that I'm having an anxiety attack. And I'm saying that because it seems like the authority are just doing things to get on my nerves and piss everybody off who's a wrestling fan, ruining the wrestling business. That's what their contribution to WWE has been ever since 2013, seemingly. I don't know what it is with the authority, but the authority just love pissing us off. Obviously, that's why they're there. But when you look at the record low ratings WWE have been seeing, who else can you put the blame on? The authority have to go. That is the solution out of what's going on in WWE, and until the authority are gone permanently, these low ratings, these record low ratings, are not going to cease. And we're going to be reading about that for articles on websites like ProWrestling.com for a significant amount of time, because the authority don't seem to be going anywhere anytime soon. I have called them out on virtually every one of their faults, because everything they have done, at least 90 to 95%, with the other 5% actually benefiting the company, everything they have done for 90 to 95% of the decisions they have made since 2013, and all the McMahons got on the same page as the authority when Vince McMahon, of course, made one of his final appearances on television before handing over full control of WWE to Triple H as COO and Stephanie as the principal owner of the organization. Everything they have done has been absolutely ridiculous and only beneficial to themselves. Nothing they've done have benefited Daniel Bryan. Nothing they've done have benefited John Cena. Nothing they've done have even benefited Brock Lesnar or Seth Rollins. It was just an excuse for a champion, the authority of putting all the responsibility on for carrying the proverbial torch into the future for WWE. And for some insane reason, the authority have succeeded in convincing Seth Rollins that he is in fact the future of the WWE, whether he's a fan favorite or a heel, which is absolutely fucking ludicrous. He is the worst champion I have ever seen in my life of the over 50 individuals who have held the championship. There may be a little over 65, if you actually put it into perspective, how many people have held the WWE Championship over the years and the various versions of the title we have seen come in through the various generations. But Seth Rollins, of the, say, 60 through 65 champions we have seen, a little over 50, has been absolutely ridiculous, and I think he has to go. If anything, they should definitely get Kane away from the authority, too, because seeing him as a director of operations is not as effective as seeing him as a mass character. I think the authority just are absolutely atrocious. And after what they did to Sting at WrestleMania 31, I said, you know, enough is enough. The authority and Triple H have to go. I have also gone as far as to challenge Triple H to a match at a WrestleMania in the near future. Don't know if he's going to accept for WrestleMania 32, but the challenge is still being thrown out there by myself. There's got to be somebody out there to do something about the authority And if Sting and other individuals who oppose the threat to the authority say Sting and Daniel Bryan can't get the job done, not even Brock Lesnar, I'm going to have to step up to the challenge and challenge Triple H to a match at WrestleMania 32. Don't know if he's going to accept, but with these anxiety attacks he's been giving me, I think that I have more than reason enough to challenge Triple H for everything he's done wrong with the wrestling business. Criticize Mr. CM Punk as much as you want, but CM Punk has been making a lot of valuable points on his Twitter recently, and he's been making a lot of valuable points for years, really, in his feud with Triple H and how he didn't agree with the direction Triple H was taking the WWE in. He said, you know, you're what's wrong with the business, and I concur with CM Punk and his analogy of what Triple H is doing to the business and what's wrong with the business. If it's not Vince McMahon and John Laurinaitis having the proverbial finger pointed towards them, it's definitely Triple H, and I think that something has to be done about Triple H, not before too long, because everything he's doing is just absolutely ridiculous. And you can criticize me all you want. You know, Triple H, you can say, is benefiting the business, and oh, no, that he hasn't. He definitely has benefited the business.